more of an idea than a person in a lot of ways. I think when you live in a realm where the ceiling is so low and the impression is so serious and you're alone, you know, it becomes more about the path that she's on, and the trajectory that she's on, the focus forward, I think, more than any one person. It's a cause, I think. You know, I think Trudy, she carries Trudy with her always. So.
The show is amazing, but it's also very serious. I was curious what the atmosphere is like on set. Do you guys ever have a chance to kind of cut loose and have fun, or is it just all work all the time?
We have a gas. We really do. We have a really great time.
We lost at the end of the day together, actually, so that was the most recent.
It was the first day of the season for shooting, and the two of us collapsed into a giggle fit in the middle of working, which is utterly unprofessional.
It happens, and you know what? Thank goodness, because it is such a... serious world for them.
It almost seems as because it's so dark that the levity that we have in between, it sort of offsets the ability to be able to go to those deep dark places and be more honest and open, I think.
What was your favorite scene shooting for the season?
Season 3?
Yes.
That's hard. How much time do we have? For different reasons, there are always scenes that you love and scenes that you loathe and scenes that are daunting. And I don't have a favorite right off the top of my head at the moment. Apologies.
Do I?
Yeah.
Oh. You guys have seen it, right?
Yes.
Okay, so the Fifth Avenue, the parade. John Smith's parade, as he has been elevated. It was a really intense, beautiful day. We had 300 background there. We had 50 makeup artists who were shooting in this huge open lot that they had built, a whole bunch of what you see on screen. And we had green screens. We had 20 green screens that were being moved around by machines constantly outdoors. And it was just logistically one of those days where you go, this is what I do. Like, it was a really, the scale of it was extraordinary. My least favorite scene was having to take care of Alice Adler.
Speaking of the scale, since shooting the first season, has production at all, have you noticed, like, the scale changing or upgrading since, or has it kind of been kind of an intimate set, or do you feel like it's kind of bigger?
Intimate. I mean, certainly, our production designer, Drew Button, is a genius, just hands down a genius, and creates the most magnificent spaces for us and has done since day one, so it doesn't feel like it's shifted really. We have much larger sequences certainly, and in the third season obviously towards the end that whole set piece was it's an airplane hangar, the thing is enormous, so that certainly is the biggest, I think.
It is. That being said, starting shooting season 4, not going to give anything away, but there is the largest stunt sequence that has ever happened on The Man in the High Castle in the first episode, and it's a feat what they have put together. Yeah, our two stunt coordinators, our one this year because Jeff left. We have a married couple who are our stunt coordinators on the show, or have been up until this year, but now Maya Aru is our coordinator, and she put together an incredible sequence. Yeah.
Can you tell us if you were both personally involved with that stunt, or...
I will never.
What about the character journeys this year? I mean, how would you say, what kind of journeys or evolutions do you think they're on through the course of this third season? How would you describe how the characters are changing?
I don't know. What kind of journeys
they're on? Yeah, as a person, as people.
Helen starts in such a place of deep devastation, and she's utterly heartbroken. And unable to, I think, even cope in any way. So what I feel like is throughout the course of the season, you see her completely fall apart at the seams, and then come back to some strength. I get goosies when I think about it, because she arrives back at certainly the woman and the character that I began to get to know in seasons 1 and 2, of making this really strong decision for the primary reason of protecting her daughters, and that's everything. So it was a really fun sort of melting and then coming back together towards the end.
I think for me,
the end of two, certainly, to be honest, we find her in that really broken place, and she has to find a way forward. I think she's the kind of person ultimately in this season where if you sit still for too long and really sit in what you've experienced and what you may not be able to continue. And I think she's just trying to survive ultimately. And obviously the mid-season arc of it all was extremely painful and difficult, and she carries that with her as well. So, she's a soldier. She's got to keep going.